my professional journey started as an engineer. So I studied engineering in South Africa in Stellenbosch, electronic engineering. And immediately after my studies, had this dream of developing digital solutions for the African continent. But it took a couple of years for us to actually get to delivering what we now can refer to as scalable solutions that's used across a number of countries. So it was a 20-year journey. Started specifically in the healthcare industry as an enabler in improving access to health services. But since then, we've supported a number of different industries, agriculture, financial services, education, and then ultimately also supporting local government in delivering services to their citizens. So access to clean water, access to electricity. Personally, I've always been drawn to the potential of the continent and the people, the innovation and the potential of the people of the continent. So it was a natural, after finishing my studies, it was absolutely the natural thing for us to focus on. So combining the benefits of technology and translating that into economic benefit for the citizens of the continent. And I think that from a timing point of view, and I'm giving away my age here, but when we commenced or started this journey about 20 years ago, at that time, as a continent, we've not participated in any of the three previous industrial revolutions. As a continent, we've not been able to translate what was at the time a technology benefit, let's say steam or electricity or the benefits of microprocessing laptops, computers. We've not been able to translate those benefits into economic benefit for the citizens. So economists referred to it as the challenge of economic diffusion. And with the advent of mobile, we've realized this will be the first opportunity for us as a continent not only to benefit from these innovations, but really to also contribute in co-creating solutions that speak to local needs and requirements and opportunities. So for the first time, we've seen, specifically in financial services, that Africa as a continent has been a global thought leader in developing new innovative financial service products, which we now refer to in general as fintech. So mobile money, just to mention one, is a concept that started in Kenya, in East Africa, a product name called M-Pesa by a telecommunication company, Safaricom. And as we speak, there's hundreds of millions of people using mobile money as a means to transact across the continent and also globally. So we've exported that capability to other regions. Mezzanine currently support a range of projects and services across 12 countries in Africa. To highlight one which has been very relevant during the COVID pandemic is how do we use technology to improve food security for rural communities. We've partnered again with a number of organizations, banks, insurers, input provider companies, processors food products, beverage products, in developing a digital marketplace that allow small-scale farmers or subsistence farmers. Majority of smallholder and subsistence farmers in Africa is confined to a hyper-local marketplace, meaning they are not tied or linked to formal value chains, both on the input side and on the off-taking side. And we've, in effect, used the benefits of mobile technology in allowing farmers to transact with formal value chains. So meaning buying a good quality seed or good quality inputs, fertilizer or plant nutrition products, and the ability to then sell produce into a formal off-taking value chain. And in doing this, improving both food security for own consumption, better yields, better quality, plus then being able to get a better price as part of participating in an off-taking transaction. So I think a lot of the work we do and our focus really is how do we enable local stakeholders. So I'm specifically referring to local entrepreneurs, local innovators, local small, medium enterprises to create value, so to develop digital products, and then secondly, to deliver the value to the target audience, and then very important, the ability to monetize the delivery of the value in order to be able to do it in a sustainable way and to scale it to more beneficiaries. Our focus as Mezzanine is to create a more conducive environment to lower some of the barriers to entry for these innovators and startup companies. And the role that business can play in African creating what we refer to as productive societies, I think there's three thematic areas which I strongly believe each and every business person on the continent should include in their KPIs. So the first is investment in human capital. I think as a collective, we should do more in making sure that our skills base is relevant for the next phase of growth, which is digital technology enabled. Then secondly, support SMEs in becoming part of the formal economy. So majority of SMEs in the continent is part of what we can refer to as an informal economy, meaning they're not contributing to the tax base. They don't have access to what we see as a formal set of transaction capabilities, bank accounts, the ability to transact both locally but also cross-border. So business, especially large enterprises, multinationals, need to hold governments accountable for creating a more conducive environment for and incentives for SMEs to become part of a formal value chain. And then thirdly, I think that the important topic is if we take into account that only 45% of citizens in the continent have a form of identity, as business, we should absolutely hold government accountable in making sure that all our citizens do have identity, not only a digital identity, but also economic identity. And just this very small change will bring massive impact with respect to allowing people to interact and transact both locally and cross-border. On the topic of entering new markets, so if we refer to a market as a country or maybe within a country, it can be a new region. I think it's absolutely important to acknowledge that each and every market, each and every country, each and every region within our countries is so unique in so many different ways. In a country like Nigeria, and I've only learned this after doing business there for many years, you've got more than 80 different languages. So to think you can transact and develop solutions for a country and see it as a uniform opportunity or segment is a massive mistake. So I think our philosophy really is that part of creating solutions and taking solutions and services to new markets is to allow for the co-creation of the solutions, meaning that the ultimate beneficiary and or the stakeholders that consume the offering and the service, for them to co-create the offering and how the offering is delivered and how the offering has been consumed and how the offering typically monetized in the last mile. Or we see our role as just basically creating, removing barriers to entry, creating a more conducive environment for businesses to create local content. We strongly believe that in Kenya, Mezzanine representatives are Kenyans. In Ghana, it's Ghanaians. In Nigeria, it's Nigerians. We do not have in one of our markets expats that we appoint in leadership. We absolutely believe in local leadership and investing in local relationships. I choose to focus on the positives. And there's so many reasons not to engage. There's so many reasons not to invest. If one look at the media and the noise, I think as a Christian, what is for me personally important is the relationships. It's about people. It's about unlocking the potential that I believe reside within people to do good, to do better, to do more. With respect to building relationships in entering a new market, it is really important to for your engagement to be authentic. It's not about your product. It's not about the service you offer. It's about being authentic with respect to what is your ultimate purpose with your engagement. And if the purpose of the engagement is to spread the good word and help where you can, if you're in a position to help, then those relationships will multiply long after you've left the marketplace or the specific engagement. And I think with respect to really the kingdom principles in saying that, how do we scale the intent? How do we scale the goodwill that we see within our communities, within our business community, beyond your personal engagements and your personal contribution? And I think it's a journey. I've learned so much from my friends, my colleagues, my customers. And it's really a humbling experience going into new markets, new industries, and just realize each time the untapped potential. I believe business as a business community and a marketplace need to create opportunities for the youth in which they can contribute in creating productive societies. That will continue to multiply long after we have left the specific setting or the specific marketplace.